So audience, a quick introduction about Mr. Jagan Mantha. He's a content creator, he's a content writer, he's a transition mentor, coach. He's worked with companies like NIT, Rourkela, Tata Motors in Jamshedpur. He's worked as a behavior specialist with Wipro. And he's done a lot of leadership workshops, and he has his own book which is written and he's really passionate about, which is called Will, Skill and Chill. So Venkat Karu, a quick introduction about yourself before we start the game.
Thank you, Ravi Shankar Garu. I'm thankful to having me in this show. So Jagan Mantha. So I generally call myself Mantha, Man Hai, Man Rahega. So I am always like a past, present, future kind of a person, actually. So the Will, Skill, Chill, actually, that's a book that I have written. Actually, I consider myself a transition specialist because I have done a series of transitions, actually, both life and career transitions, almost 20 years of transition experience, which kind of morphed into a book that nearly took 13-14 months to write. But I wrote it in a very, very simple frame, using movies, our own Ramayana, Mahabharata, small tidbits, and my own personal shares. So, yeah, content writer, that's something that built over a period of time, last 15 years, with a blog writer. So I try to help others who need help.
Great. Thanks a lot, Andy. Let's quickly get into the rapid fire question so that we get to know you better. So, okay. What is your best feature? What is that you're really good at?
Okay, best feature is situational humor, Andy. That's something. See, now we are in lockdown. I think in lockdown, people either have zero or one or two of these two problems. Okay, zero, one, or two of these two problems. Too little daru or too much of joru. Juru as in wife.
Daru and juru. Okay, rhyming.
And too little of daru. I mean, of course, now the liquor shops are opened, actually. But too much of joru, actually, everybody, staying and all the time, getting each other's nerves, actually. But for me, both happened for an extended period in the last several years, because for 24 years, I was into corporate. But now last 4-5 years, I've been largely working from home guy. So I've experienced this a lot.
Great. What is the song you hear the most often? The repeated song which you play whenever you want to listen to it. So what is that song? Which song is it?
Okay, that's a Hindi song, and actually a song from Golmaal. So aane wala pal bhi jaane wala hai, ho sake to isme zindagi guzaro. Like, live this moment fully, because this moment is actually very fleeting. It will go away. So it's actually a movie that I saw as a teenager, and it actually keeps reminding me that, okay, life is fleeting, but then live this moment.
Good. Very, very apt for this particular situation. What have you done which you're really proud of the most? It can be with your career, at your family life. What is that you're really proud of?
Proud ante the challenge that I have faced most, which in a way, I tripped and cried a lot when this problem happened. My mother was wheelchair for nearly 10 years. So my midlife crisis hit me very early in 2000. So I was barely 31, 32 at that time. And I was having my childbirth at that time, 2001. So why me? Why me? I was going through that phase. But then somehow, to balance myself, I went into training and development. Then, but you give a lot of gyan to others, na? You think, actually, how much am I applying? So it happened over a period of time.
Okay, so who is your superhero that has always given you that extra power during your childhood?
Superhero ante actually, I have written extensively about it in my book also. Choti Si Baat ani movie undandi Hindi lo, Amol Palekar and Ashok Kumar, actually. Amol Palekar is this shy guy,
okay,
very shy and inadequate. Mm-hmm. But then he gets mentored by Ashok Kumar. So I saw myself as that Amol Palekar character when I was a teenager, wanting to be that colonel character, that mentor character, So, that's what I reflect, that, okay, it's very small, slow steps to try to get there.
Great. So, you know fortune cookies, right? So, if you have a chance that you want to pick up a fortune cookie, what is that you would expect, expect out of that fortune cookie?
Okay. So let everybody get their fortune, what they really want. That's what I would want. That's what I want my cooking. Let everybody get what they really want, but then yeah, and have also the means to get it.
Okay. What if you won $1 million, you know, today, what would you do with it? What would be your priority?
$1 million, that's, that, first and foremost, my wife will be extremely happy. So 50% of it, I will give it to her and 50% I will unabashedly spend on two causes that I love most. One is mental health, mental health. And the other one is de-addiction, Andy. Actually, I, de-addiction of, you know, all the vices in the society. Yeah.
Nice. If you had a time machine, where would you like to go? Which year and, you know, which location would you like to go? Provided you had the time machine with you now.
Time machine, okay. That's the Aditya 369 kind of a movie. That, actually, Aditya 369 movie, when I was seeing, not bad if I can go to Krishnadevaraya time, actually. That's what Balakrishna went, actually. And, really, is that really that splendor was there or not? You know, going and seeing that doesn't hurt, actually.
Great. So, who was your, you know, what was your favorite cartoon show while growing up?
Favorite cartoon show? And I was actually not into much of a cartoons. During childhood, I was drawn too much by Chandamama, actually. I was a very introverted child. But Chandamama and Veera Hanuman. Veera Hanuman, I don't think he's a caricature character, actually. He's like a childhood, what do you call, a role model, actually. So, I was mightily drawn and inspired by what... Hanuman is actually. Hanuman, I always like try to relate to Hanuman in many ways. So, can't say cartoon character, but childhood role model nevertheless. Yeah.
So, what is the weapon of your choice if you had to really fight? Not with your pen, but...
No. My weapon of the choice is very clear, Andy. Pen is mightier than the sword. I try to use the pen all the time. Pen as well as pun. Pen as well as pun, because I picked this from my dad. It is not the hammer sometimes, it is the humor sometimes which can work.
So, where would you like to retire? I mean, do you want to live in the city, or, you know, if you would like to go to other location and settle there, what would be that?
Well, I'm actually not a very physically surrounding person. Actually, I mean myself, I'm very blissful, actually. So I would rather go with my wife's choice, because I would rather, like, I'm very, very thankful that my wife didn't divorce me and I went through all the challenges. My father, like, for 20 years now, he has been a heart patient, but he's still by my side. And my mother was like wheelchair fit. That's the reason why I bend over backwards sometimes, you know, for the sake of, you know, my wife's actually in-laws. I generally pun that, okay, out of law, nahi hona hai. But the point is that I want to make her happy.
Yeah. Tea guy, coffee guy?
Actually, I'm a guzzler of water. And it hydrates. I mean, of course, tea and coffee, I will just limit it to one or two. Neither tea nor coffee. I'm a zuggler as well as a guzzler.
Okay.
Zuggle with gas and guzzle with water.
Great. Next question. You know, if what is the term for success? You know, as per you, you know, should people aspire for money, wealth, position, or healthy life? What's your mantra? Life mantra.
Whatever people want success. Everybody doesn't have the same definition of success. But I mean, I have my own definition of success. Sometimes using word pun actually. So success ends with a word called cess. Cess means actually tax. While it comes in the end in the success, but it needs to be upfront paid actually. It needs to be, cess need to be upfront paid for whatever success you want, but often in excess. So if you're willing to pay the cess upfront, often in excess for whatever success you want, success is yours, but you need to do the upfront payment actually and without complaining actually. I know it's a little philosophical, but that's what it is.
So if women have to really impress you, what should they do? What really impresses you? It's, what do you expect from people to impress you?
No, I don't want to get it right on the wrong side of my wife. So that's a question I would rather pass. But so the thing is, of course, if they really want to impress me, then I mean, it's difficult because my wife has already impressed me enough. not by her external demeanor, though, whatever she has done for my family. I know I'm already praising it her second time, because that's so rare these days.
Let's change the gender. So, let's change the gender. And, you know, what do you expect men to impress you, or, you know, people, friends?
Men need to impress me with their humor, because my standard of humor, like, in the sense, humor is like a subtle humor.
Mm-hmm.
So I generally, because my Will Still Chill actually is 40% of this book. Chill is like being able to humor yourself even when life is hard, you know. So if somebody is actually able to smile genuinely, not for fake, mm-hmm. then I'll get rest.
Great. So thank you, Jagannir. I mean, this was like really rapid, good responses on that. So now you are the CM for 1 minute. So if you're a CM for 1 minute, what are the things you could bring in? What are the positive changes you could bring in?
Yeah. So I fundamentally want to solve the daru problem as well as the joru problem, actually, because these are two big issues. I mean, the thing is why fundamentally I want to get to the root cause of like why these problems are happening, not just do surface level fixes. We need a greater appreciation of each other from the genders, and that requires not gyan. Gyan is yawning. Okay, so it needs a different approach. Okay, so I will get the best brains to work on these two big problems, the daru problem and the joru problem, actually.
Great. Thank you, Jagan Garu. I mean, what is that help you can provide? I mean, what is that intellectual help you can provide if somebody has to reach you and then connect with you? What are the insights with your experience you can share?
So I have pursued this transformational education for a long time, landmark, about 4 years, and done some 2,000 hours of volunteering. I have seen people, when they drop their garb, how vulnerable they are, how vulnerable they can be.
Right.
So I know even Murthy Garu was telling yesterday, very, 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 I mean, people generally suffer, you know. So Hindi wala suffer or Angrezi wala suffer, like both happens, actually. Suffer is a journey and the other suffer is suffering. So both can be actually reduced if we can be honest and authentic with ourselves. So my attempt has been to write this book. 2 chapters are free, actually. If you can find it in Kindle, just read the approach with which I write. I talk about big problems, like even Coffee Day founder gave it up one day. Okay, so many a times, so-called external trappings of success are not the real indication. What people are actually really dealing with stuff. And it needs more work, actually. And that has been my effort. And people can actually reach out to me to have authentic conversations. I mean, mm-hmm. I usually do the first conversation for no strings attached. Very authentic conversation for people to see whatever their stuff is.
Thanks a lot, Jagan Garu. I think that's a beautiful conversation, and thanks for that approach of helping somebody who needs your skill set and your support. Thanks, audience, and let's meet with another celebrity as soon, another friend.
I'm first and foremost really, really thankful. I'm just not
you with this social distancing. So thank you, Jagan Garu.
Social distancing is for emotional closeness, and you are actually doing wonderful there.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Yeah. Take care, Andy. Bye-bye.
Thank you.